Okay, I got good side tones over here. How you hear me?
You hear me good?
Loud and clear. All right, so right now, you're on comm 2 for your transmitter. Ground's in there right now. When we put ATIS in there, we should be able to pick that up just fine. That's tower on one and ground
on the other. All right, so we want to go...
So we want to go to ATIS, so we'll put 123.85 on comm 2 down here.
85.
Flicker, Prevention Juliet, 175.10 the weather, wind 15011, visible 10, few clouds 1,600, scattered 2,200, temperature 302.23, altimeter 3009, ILS pressure use Flicker reserve, we're landing runway 19. Notice Chairman, runway 1432 closed, restricted lower pressures approved, advise Flicker pressure control, Flicker tower potential contact, you have air Prevention Juliet.
Information Juliet, the wind is 15011.
Flicker, Prevention Juliet, 1751 Zulu weather. Wind 15011, visible 10. Few clouds 1,600, scattered 2,200, temperature 302.23. Altimeter 3009. ILS pressure use Flicker reserve, we're landing runway 19. Notice Chairman, runway 1432 closed, restricted lower pressures approved, advise Flicker pressure control, Flicker tower potential contact, you have air Prevention Juliet.
Okay, so, you can go ahead and shut him up so much. He's supposed to get a 121.9 now. Now you got a little bit less noise while you're asking your question.
Yeah, so it's going to be Waco ground, Skyhawk 1080 Foxtrot.
And then he gets attention.
He's going to respond.
No, he's 0 Foxtrot, Waco ground, go ahead.
We're at the T-Hanger 31 on the East T-Hangers. We have information Juliet, and we want to, where are we going?
Ready, taxi. We're going to be westbound departure, because we will be out of Delta for just a few minutes, but I'll do that demo.
Westbound departure.
Yep. You're just having a conversation.
Waco ground, Skyhawk 1080 Foxtrot.
Skyhawk 1080 Foxtrot, Waco ground.
Ready to taxi with information Juliet, and we want to be westbound departure. 80 Foxtrot.
Skyhawk 80 Foxtrot, runway 19, taxi via Delta Alpha.
Runway 19, taxi via Alpha Delta.
Delta Alpha.
Delta Alpha, 80 Foxtrot.
Okay, flaps up for taxi. Here we go. Got it coming up on my side, looks good. If it does that when you're adding power for taxi, you can always add some mixture. I just got it good and leaked out for you so we didn't carbon anything up while we were sitting here. Okay, you're clear of your obstacles on the right, so let's look at our wind direction, 150, climb into, dive away from, so what do we need to do? Wind's behind you, dive away from.
150?
It's behind you, dive away from. Dive away, there you go.
You know what, I always get confused because I'm thinking the runway is this way, but it's actually...
That's why you use the heading indicator as a reference when you're taxiing.
Over here, yeah, it's behind us.
Yeah.
I see what you're saying.
Remember,
okay.
The runway we're going to depart on, yes, is runway 19, but the wind's at 150. That's a pretty decent difference.
Yeah.
Just a 1080 Foxtrot. Did you want flight following?
Alright, negative. We'll be just outside the Delta for a few minutes and then right back in for the option with you.
Roger.
I'll tell you what we'll use as a reference. We'll go out here to Cougar Land. That way we've got an airstrip to look at, but we're not so far away. But I think that demo will really drive the point home.
Okay.
Now, as we practice this engine failure thing more and at higher altitudes, there is a litany you're going to learn for getting the airplane restarted, for communicating the emergency, and for all that. But what I really want to build into you first is this instinct to maintain control of the airplane and figure out where you're going. And if I give you some scenarios where we're a little bit lower and we have to land, I think it builds that a whole lot better than taking you up there at 3,500 feet, failing the engine, going through the litany, and then being like, okay, it's all good now, the engine's back.
I see. Thanks, Ben. I think that's going to be a scrap deal, huh?
I haven't heard anything to the contrary. I know he wants the avionics out of it.
So they didn't come down, or he forgot to put them down?
I think he forgot to put them down.
Oh.
Whatever the case is, it's clear that he was making power when he touched down, because the shape the prop is in is either windmill or he's making power, but my bet is he's making power. And alternate gear extension of those single engine Cessnas is just a hydraulic hand pump, so even if there's an electrical issue, you can still use that. So the scenario I could think of where maybe it's a legit system issue that kept him from doing that, maybe he thought he had a fire and he just wanted to not screw with that and get on the ground right now. I don't know. I just know that he landed, and it took, I think the number I heard is it took the airport manager 23 minutes to get here from his house because it's after hours, and by the time Joel got here, the pilot had split and is not returning phone calls.
Really?
So
is that against the law?
No, he's well within his rights, but it just doesn't play like somebody who's, you know, trying to be part of the system and do the right thing, you know?
Right. So I want to pour it right towards the wind, right?
Yep, we got good cooling.
Alright, check full range of motion. No obstructions. Step on the on the right. Step on the left. Elevator goes up and down. Rudder. You know what, I didn't straighten my wheel.
Yeah, it's cocked just a little bit. Yeah, that's better.
Alright, so we're gonna...
There you go.
Alright, 1700. We're gonna lean it. Temperature's good, we got good amps, we're in the suction.
Let's go ahead and check the mags as well.
Oh, I did that out of sequence, didn't I?
Yeah, excellent.
Left mags, got a little drop, going to right. Little drop, back to both. Now we check the carb heat.
There we go. And we'll check it with the carb heat on at idle too.
Alright, we're going to come back to full idle. All the way out. Got a little drop. Back to 1,000. Alright, what am I forgetting here?
Go ahead and double check yourself on the checklist. Now, there's not as much on there as what we've done, but just make sure we didn't miss anything big.
Okay, we reset that. Check the magnetos, we check the suction, carburetor heat, radio's already set. Strobe lights.
Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and go strobe and landing on. Good and visible now.
Throttle fiction lock. That. That's it, right?
Alright, so let's go ahead and flip up to COM 1 on the transmitter, that way we're on tower. And let's go through the killer items one more time. We're on both in the detent. Flaps are where we think they are, trim's where we think it is. And once you get our clearance, it's going to be my takeoff because I'm going to demonstrate the engine failure.
I can go ahead and line up, can I?
Yeah, yeah. That way you've seen it once before it gets done to you.
We're doing before it gets done to me. Uh-oh, that didn't sound good.
Frequency change approved, 50 golf.
50 golf, no.
Yep, Vladimir's up there with an instrument student and one of my police specs.
Oh, really?
Yep. You are on tower, you're on COM 1, you got tower loaded, you got the volume up where we can hear it because we heard him clear her for a frequency change. No need to give it attention, he already knows we're out here, so wait to the tower, who are you, where are you, what do you want?
So I'm Waco Tower, Skyhawk 80, 1080 Foxtrot at runway 19er, ready for takeoff.
Perfect.
Waco Tower, Skyhawk 1080 Foxtrot. At runway 19er, ready for takeoff.
Skyhawk 1080 Foxtrot, Waco Tower, runway 19er, clear for takeoff, wind 180 at 12.
Clear for takeoff, 19er.
Clear for takeoff, 19er, 80 Foxtrot.
Okay, my controls.
Why is it all of a sudden getting rough there? Do you feel that?
There might have been a little bit of wind blowing through the backside of your prop blade. It'll sound different when it's doing that. Final's clear. Here comes one of my absolute favorite exercises.
Really?
Goes into the wind, on the center line, the right runway, here comes our power. Good RPMs, airspeed's alive. Off we go. And boom, engine failure. Oh, there it is. Nose down. Flare.
Holy crap.
I take a breath. Oh, there it is. I was expecting it, right? Nose down, and then flare. If I'd immediately flared, I'd stall up a little bit high. You'll get plenty of practice at those.
Okay. So it's a really quick flare. I mean, it's...
Yeah, I was pretty low when it happened. I was only about 20 foot when it happened, so I got that nose down, made sure I had some speed to play with. Yep, here comes the runway, then we flare.
Okay.
Alright, your controls.
My controls.
Your controls, you really need probably a little bit of nose down trim, feels like. And when you're ready, we can turn out about...
Okay, 80 Foxtrot, right turn out approved.
Right turn out approved for 80 Foxtrot.
Right about 290 on the heading, we're going to go 1,500 feet.
But I'm still going 19 here, right?
Until you get 1,000 feet, then we can make that turn.
1,000 feet, okay. Normally it's 1,200, why are we changing?
We're not seeing in the pattern.
I got it. 80 Foxtrot, you can remain at frequency, advise when you want to come in though.
80 Foxtrot, roger.
80 Foxtrot, roger.
Yep, 290, 1,500 feet.
Golf 80 Foxtrot, I'm receiving negative mode C.
Copy, we'll recycle CDC soon.
I know.
That's the way to save face on that, but we'll recycle it for you.
Tag 80 Foxtrot, stay altitude.
I'm showing 1,500 Easter Foxtrot.
Tag 80 Foxtrot, roger, I'm showing you now at 1,400. 3007.
3007, good.
Alright, there's 2200 on the RPM, we're at 295, 290.
Coming up on 500 AGL. we lose our engine and say, man, that runway sure is tempting. I'm going to turn back for that runway. Feel my shoulder here?
Uh-huh.
So I'm supposed to get lined up on this thing and land on it before I hit the ground, right? And I'm panicking because I'm not expecting this.
But you wouldn't be turning this sharp though, would you?
I'm panicking, man. I'm not controlling my speed.
So we missed it.
Yeah. We're 200 AGL right now.
There ain't no way.
100 AGL. There's the ground. You're in this field right here, probably as a result of a stall spin.
Yeah.
So what were our alternatives? And I just went straight forward. Let's take a look. We'll find the runway out there again. Look at that. I got a nice big field right there. There are some houses and trees past it. I may have landed in the trees, but it would have been under control.
Right.
Look at how fast we hit the ground, though. That 500 feet went away real quick because I got so fixated on making that runway, I wasn't paying attention to my glide speed, I wasn't paying attention to how steep I was turning. I was fixated on that runway, and I ran out of altitude and options real quick.
Yeah.
Below 1,000 AGL, we land straight ahead.
Okay, so what you want to do is do what you did on the runway, is just
lower the nose, make sure I got best glide speed,
and then
land.
Take it on the chin into the trees.
Yeah. I'm gonna land straight ahead under control.
Alright,
I got us on right base to 1-9. Gear controls, go ahead and let tower know that we are inbound for the option. You can set the power where you want to.
Flight controls.
Gear controls.
Alright, and we need to tell tower that we're inbound.
Yep,
so
inbound.
Just say Waco Tower.
Scott Gates, your Foxtrot's back inbound for the option.
Waco Tower, Skyhawk 80 Foxtrot is back inbound for the option.
Skyhawk 1080 Foxtrot, runway 19er, clip the option, wind 1609er, gusting 16. Say request on the go.
Clear for the option 19er, continued traffic, continued close traffic.
Clear for the option 19er, continued traffic, close traffic.
Roger, left or right, close shaft approved.
We'll make it left.
We'll be going left traffic, 80 Foxtrot.
Okay, normal landing.
So I want to get, I'm on like an extended base leg right here, right?
Yeah.
So how do I know how far?
That's a good question. It's really a judgment call. We remove one of the legs, the patterns, you have to adapt to that a little bit. I'd say right about here, I'd go ahead and do my gumps check.
Alright, gas on both, undercarriage is down and welded, mixture, power, seatbelts and harnesses.
Okay. And since we're fairly tight on base, I'd go ahead and...
That's what I thought too.
No, don't light it out and you'll go for the way to the airport. Just go ahead and start your configuration here.
Alright.
So get that power set.
This soon, huh?
Yeah.
Power 1500, carb heat on.
Yeah, go ahead and get that first notch of flaps out, start slowing the airplane
right
down.
We're below 110, so we can use the flaps. We said left traffic, so...
After this option, yes.
Yeah, okay. And so, what are we doing here now? I'm landing, or then I'm going to...
You're doing the...
On the takeoff, we're going to do the practice thing.
No, you're not going to do that this time. We're just going to get a few normal landing reps in first.
Okay.
When we do the engine failure, it's going to be full length, so we'll have one where I have you actually exit the runway and taxi back. There's no need to turn a training scenario into a real emergency, so when we practice that, it's going to be on full wing intake. Position where your entire final can be a power reduction story instead of a power addition story. That's nice. out here if you want any more flaps.
So I want to slow down a little bit, right?
Yep.
Do you need more flaps?
I'd go ahead and put more flaps out, but we want to slow our speed now at 65, right?
Right. Alright, so almost 70.
Use your trim. Pitch for airspeed, power for altitude.
Alright, there's 65.
And where are we looking?
Down the runway.
Way down that runway. There you go. Hold it off, 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 hold it off. Keep that back pressure in there. Why'd you let go of that back pressure?
Hell, I don't know.
Everything you got. Pop that wheelie. Alright, car peed off. Flaps up. And here we go. Got a little bit of nose up trim, so it's going to want to pitch up. It's a little bit normal takeoff. We'll be prepared for that. Another normal landing next. Get that right rudder in there.
So this time we're going to 1200 and then left traffic.
Exactly. Everything's normal.
Why do I keep getting this weird yawing action?
Because you're not holding constant right rudder. The good and the bad of an airplane is it's almost always going to do exactly what you tell it to do.
Tell you what, I'll be glad when it's cooler weather.
Me too, and this is actually a nice day today.
Yeah, right.
Change.
Alright, so there's 1200 almost.
Got a turn, 1500 I'm downwind. Make sure you're climbing through the turn here. Coordinated climb. There we go. Except for one day this week. Okay, Gump's check.
Gas on both, undercarriage is down and welded. Mixture is set, the power is set. Seatbelts and harnesses. Let me ask you something.
Uh-huh.
We just blow through these mixture and power settings. How do we know? I mean,
is the power at idle right now? No. Is the power at full right now?
So it's power at 2200. That's
yeah,
the power I want.
Power set for a nice slow cruise on downwind. Mixture is not full rich. We usually don't want it full rich unless it's a really cool day. It's just making you look at everything. Hey, is everything where it's supposed to be?
Right.
Is anything out of the ordinary?
Alright, so I'm going to do a beam the numbers, or a beam the...
Let's use the 1,000-foot markers.
1,000-foot markers, okay.
Yeah, Hoggy, 0 Fox, start runway 19er, clip the option.
And that'll be right there.
19er, 0 9er.
Right?
19er, 0 Fox, start. Yep.
Alright, so power to 1,500, carb heat on, first notch of flaps. Get a little descent going here. Much.
What do you fix that with, left hand or right hand?
Power.
There you go.
Central RFF, I've just done their information, come back to Sigma 22 Central Valley for Texas, available high level flight first frequency.
More convective SIGMETs. 25, target speed.
Way high.
Yep, got the runway made, I'd call it idle it.
We just get a stupid thing break going. Looking down that runway. There you go. Good reaction. Now we're ready for the real flare. Just pull it off, pull it off, pull it off. Once those mains are on, keep that yoke all the way back. That yoke needs to be to the left because your wind's mostly from the left. You don't fly because the center line's over here. Flaps up. Copy off.
50 Golf, roger. Correction, Skyhawk, 80 Foxtrot, roger, clear to land.
Oh man, 80 Foxtrot.
Might be a little low on this one, it feels like. Second notch flat.
Okay. Better get that left wing down lower. I don't need that power, but I do need that nose low. I need to quit down the runway and start using my feet. You're not using your feet at all right now. Point the nose.
Looking down that runway, keep that nose straight. All the back pressure, keep that wheel in the wind, keep the back pressure in there. Follow through, right? All about the follow through. Let's go ahead and get off Alpha 2 here so we can taxi back. Don't turn until you're slowed down, the power needs to be idle.
That was terrible.
Gotta use your feet.
Skyhawk 80 Foxtrot, contact the ground.
Forward down, 80 Foxtrot. Way to the ground, Skyhawk 108 Foxtrot, clear of 19 on Alpha 2, request to taxi back to runway 19.
Skyhawk 108 Foxtrot, Waco ground, runway 19, taxi via Delta. I mean, Alpha.
19 via Alpha, 80 Foxtrot.
19 via Alpha, 80 Foxtrot. We can clean it up now, can't we?
Heartbeat off, flaps up. You're looking down the runway, but you're trying to fix everything with this, and that's not going to work. You got to use your feet.
Well, so you told me if I wanted to turn to use your ailerons, though, but I'm...
No.
So I do want to try and use my rudder a little bit more.
How many times have we done Dutch holes? You need to go back and watch those videos. When you're in a turn in normal flight, yeah, you're gonna lead with your control wheel and follow with your rudder, but when you're trying to do a slipping crosswind correction, which is what we're doing,
yeah,
all your ailerons are gonna do is drift you left and right.
Right.
They're not meant to point the nose. Your rudder has to point the nose straight. So like right now, let's say I've got a left-hand crosswind. I gotta have my wheel in the wind, but I gotta use my rudder to keep the airplane going straight. That's the only way the nose is gonna stay straight. You're trying to hunt for everything with this and it's not working out for you very well. You gotta use those feet. Think back to those Dutch rolls down the runway.
Okay.
That's why we did so many of those. Go back and watch those first couple of videos if you need to and look at what you were doing. By its nature, that slipping approach is uncoordinated. It's completely different from how you turn the airplane in normal flight. Normally, would we want to be going opposite rudder in a turn like that? No. But if we're doing a slip and correction, it's going to have to be opposite rudder. We're going to have to be wing into wind. And of course, the wing into the wind's making the airplane want to turn left, so you're going to have to counter it with a little bit of right rudder. But again, we shouldn't be consciously thinking that. We should just be staring down the runway and letting that muscle memory do its job, right?
Yes. I'm lagging on that part of it, but I'm doing a better job of looking down the runway, I feel like.
Now just let your muscles do what they're supposed to do. Alright, so you're going to lose your engine on takeoff here. I'm going to distract you to the extent that I can. That's just because you're idle. That's just telling you your vacuum pump's running slow. See where your suction is right now?
Mm-hmm.
Watch this. So it goes away. Anyway, I'm going to distract you as best I can, even though you know it's coming. I'm going to have you look outside at something. I'll make up something. I'll reach over, I'll idle the power, take a half second's breath, say, there it is, engine's gone, nose down.
All right.
Do that.
This is me, I'm doing this one.
This is you, yeah. There it is, engine's gone, nose down, like you were expecting it. And then we'll figure out where we need to flare at.
All right, you're going to help me, right?
Yeah, but the first thing is getting that nose down, right? If we don't do that, we're not in control of where we flare at. I'll idle the power. Your job is to say, there it is, engine's gone, nose down, and actually do that. Then, once we've landed, we'll resume our takeoff. Go back to tower. Ready for takeoff?
Here.
Ready for takeoff 19, close traffic.
Waco Tower, Skyhawk 80 Foxtrot is at runway 19, ready for takeoff, close traffic, left traffic.
Skyhawk 1080 Foxtrot, Waco Tower runway 19, clear for takeoff.
Clear for takeoff, 80 Foxtrot.
Okay, gas is on board.
With us to an echo,
neutral, flaps are up, here we go.
Departure, enter, or correction, across the runway center line to the east.
Roger. Looking for the traffic, 421 and
Roger.
Expecting 01.
Princess 421 Echo, enter left downwind for runway 19er.
Left downwind for 19er, 421 Echo.
That's one of those
quotes. 1000 RVs with you on the
north of I-20 accident.
0R14 approach.
Alright, you ready?
I'm ready.
So 95129 Waco Tower, continue inbound.
Continue inbound on 129er.
Is that a bobcat out there? There he is, nose down. Now flare.
Do you have a runway 01 available?
Turn it up. 21 Echo, negative, enter left downwind, runway 19er.
Left downwind, 19er, 421 Echo.
Let's go.
The hell, man?
Where's the wind from? Where's the wind from?
150, it's coming from...
You know, you need to know the number. The airplane is telling you where the wind's from, right? Whose job is it to keep the airplane from getting blown?
80 Fox, I continue runway heading. I'll call your turn. Traffic is 12 o'clock, 2 miles opposite direction. Twin sets are setting up for the left downwind to 19er.
Runway heading, you'll call the turn.
Runway heading, you'll call the turn. 80 Fox, trot.
Twin sets at 421 Echo, verify you're entering left downwind, runway 19er.
Now in terms of losing the engine, that wasn't so bad, was it?
No, it wasn't bad.
What was the crappy part?
Right,
the fundamentals?
The wind pushing me off course?
I still want...
That's not doing that, so make left 360, enter the left downwind to runway 19er. I have traffic about to reach the vortex at 1700.
I still want you to say the words and I haven't.
So. About 80 Fox, turn left close traffic.
Turn left.
Left close traffic. 80 Fox, turn.
I want you to say the words. There it is, engine's gone, nose down. It's one of those things like your gumps check where if you say it, it's a whole lot more likely you're gonna do it. That's something we're gonna continue to practice on takeoffs. There it is, engine's gone, nose down.
Okay.
We act like we're expecting it.
That's 421 Echo, make left traffic now. Correction, make left turn out. Fly heading 180.
This is normal landing here. I'm gonna verify something.
421 Echo.
Go up 65, perfect.
So 95129, runway 32, clear low, approach out above 1100 traffic. At your 2 o'clock, and making a left correction heading south is a twin Cessna.
Clear for low approach, clear for low approach over 14,
21. Twin Cessna 2 and XSA current heading.
060 now.
Another 95129 cancel approach clearance, climb maintain 3000 fire runway heading.
Alright, we're in downtown airport. 95129.
I'm clear for that one
here. Intercept power sets.
I have 80 Foxtrot, continue with downwind, I'll call your base turn.
Continue with downwind, you'll call my base, 80 Foxtrot.
He's got this...
Cessna 421 Echo, runway 19 clear to land, wind 160 at 16.
This twin Cessna is massive, it's a pattern.
Cessna 129, fly heading 240, climb maintain 3000.
240, climb maintain 3000, 95129.
request left 360.
We're going to set a continue this way.
One echo, make right base, runway 19er.
Go ahead, mess this up.
Test everybody up.
Request flight ahead a little bit. Speaking to
I 421 echo traffic, 12 o'clock, 2 miles, Skyhop, northbound, 4 traffic in Bay.
Traffic in Bay.
Okay, where is this guy?
421 echo, roger, say your intentions, what do you need to do?
Left 360 to land in 19er.
So 421 echo and negative, make a right 360 present position.
Right 360 present position.
So 421 echo, make a right 260, not left.
Making right 360.
That's my 80 Fox, continue, continue off all your base.
Roger, 80 Fox, far away from that guy, we can be, we're heavy.
Skyhawk, 129 and contact departure.
Contact departure, now with the non-counter, thank you, sir.
Why'd you say that, because I gotta know what he's doing or what?
I've been listening to it for the past...
Wait a time, this is 2150 Golf.
The past 5 minutes or so, it's been a comedy.
So if 2150 Golf, like a tower, continue inbound.
Continue inbound, 5-0
Golf. System 421 Echo, are you able to make a right downwind right from that present position?
Right downwind for present position, 421 Echo.
System 421 Echo, runway 19er, clear to land.
19er clear to land. I'm going to extend a little bit around the downwind, right downwind.
He doesn't. I'm convinced that the airport layout screwed up.
80 Fox traffic at your 12 o'clock, 5 miles off the direction Skyhawk at 2,000 feet, setting up to the ILS descending. I'll have you follow him.
80 Fox truck, roger that, looking.
50 Golf traffic, 12 o'clock, 5 miles off the direction Skyhawk will follow you. He's at your 10 to 11 o'clock, 1400.
I mean, he's going to be like,
looking for that traffic.
Okay, right over here.
Yeah, the guy wasn't prepared for the airport layout's kind of what it sounds like, but
just a 421 echo runway 19er clear to land, wind 17012, are you able to make present position base?
Screwed up auto approach and an airplane on the IFR for approach.
I am flying heading 075 on downwind, making left base for 19er.
I'm not seeing this guy.
It's 5-0 golf, I'll find him.
I mean, he's 2,000 though, it should be like readily.
Yeah, there'll be a hair above us. They should be at 2,100. I don't know whether it's not 2,000, but... Where are you, Fitty?
Number 2150, call Council Coach Clearance, climb maintain 3,000, fly runway heading.
Alright.
Oh, Council approaching, climb maintain.
Set for 2150, call.
And Tower 80 Fox 5 Scott coming, 5-0 golf inside.
Okay, 0 Fox 5 Roger.
On short sign of 421 Echo.
Number 421 Echo, say again.
On short sign of 419er.
Number 421 Echo, Roger, runway 19er, clear to land 116.
You still calling my base?
19er,
yeah.
clear to land.
Trust me, you want to be going this way right now.
Okay.
He's already canceled 5-0 golf approach clearance. He's like, this guy is going to give me a headache.
I see.
Skyhawk 80 Foxtrot, are you able to make a recess for it to final runway 19er from present position?
Yeah, we can go ahead and turn final from here, 3-0 Foxtrot.
Under that, Skyhawk traps at 2500, 7-mile final. Turn left 180, set up for the visual correction approach to 19er.
Okay, left to 180, we'll keep an eye out for 5-0 golf and we'll join the final 3-0 Foxtrot. Hey, you're doing a great job today. Bring it on around
18011.
For you, 421 Echo.
Okay, from a 180 heading, join final.
From a 180 heading?
Yeah. He's just trying to intercept you on the final. He's trying to help.
I see.
Wiggle Tower says I'm 12-5-0 golf at 3,000 feet, but I'm wrong way heading.
That's 215-0 golf, contact departure, one correction, remain straight complete.
maintain your frequency, 1250.
Okay, you can put the spurs to her. He's getting out of here, so other than that twin Cessna, we should be number one.
Well, the top side, 1250 Golf, unable to maintain VFR. I'd like to see if we can make a right turn to 90 degrees to the right.
Left calling tower, say again.
With the tower, Cessna 250 Golf, unable to maintain VFR. Request 90 degree right turn.
Cessna 2150 Golf, contact approach 126.12.
So what does that mean? He was running into clouds?
Yeah.
He was setting up for an ILS to approach runway 19. The twin Cessna screwed him up. A trainer from TSTC was on the IFR approach runway 14. The twin Cessna screwed him up. Has two airplanes that he had to send around for this guy, and he had to send us halfway to Hillsboro. That's why one thing I'm going to really harp on when we start flying to unfamiliar airports is to do your homework and know where the hell you're at.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
It's one of those little things that can make your life real easy or real inconvenient.
Sure.
That the serious crash I showed you the video of in Hobby, what I believe, this is my opinion, a contributing factor will be released by the NTSB will be her unfamiliarity with the airport.
Probably, yeah.
That ended up taking precedence over her flying, unfortunately, and you see what the result is.
Well, plus she had a whole lot of traffic that they were trying to move her around.
And they were doing an awesome job with her, but if you're that unprepared for the environment you're going to be in, remember the PAVE checklist, pilot, aircraft, environment, external pressures, right?
Yeah.
If the environment and external pressures are so overwhelming, then everything else turns into a risk factor also.
Right.
So we're going to have to judge where to make that power reduction at. That's what it's long straight in. But I just want you to call it and tell me, and I'll tell you if I agree with you or not.
Okay, so I'm basically just going to add a final, and then add a base.
1280 Foxtrot Runway 19 and clear to land, wind 1, correct and clear for the option, wind 17014.
Cleared for the option for Runway 19, 80
Foxtrot. There we go.
So, final, base, and then like half a leg, or...
Okay.
Is that about right?
Yeah, I like the rationale.
Alright, I'm at 1500, that was looking good. Speed at 100. So I'm thinking maybe, like right above that that big barn right there.
Okay. Yeah, that works for me.
10th roof.
Yeah. I think that's that Reagan horse place.
But I want to stay at 1500 though, right?
Start. Yeah, you want to maintain your altitude. That way you can trade that for airspeed.
We're going to pass about 3 miles north of the field and about the landfill stop.
2150 Golf, I can tell, roger, continue inbound.
Alright, gas on both, undercarriage is down and welded, we got our mixture set and our power set, and our seatbelts and harnesses are on. Alright, so...
After all that bullcrap, now we're going to do a normal touch and go.
Yeah, right? Man, I'm way low though. Alright, so I'm going to start about right here, I think.
Okay.
So, power to 1500, carb heat on, your flaps are down, first notch.
Remember, your wheel controls your drift, your feet now are going to control the nose.
I'm up with the nose with you on the RNAV 14.
A little high though, aren't I?
I think you're just about right on. Lot easier.
495-129 on Waco Tower, Roger. Start your
rate of altitude.
Traffic.
It is to gain.
So you'll be
falling.
Right? Yeah. Good. Down 5 mile, final up 1500. Skyhawk 129 circle north of the field for a red base to runway 19er. Only 19er cleared for the option.
Circle, make a red base for 19er for the option on 19er and 129er.
Skyhawk 2150 Golf, runway 19er cleared to land number 2.
Runway 19er cleared to land number 2.
What do you think? Second notch come out?
129er number 3 following the Skyhawk 5 mile final.
Number 3, 129er.
Not so much worried about the ball here, is it just
no,
why
not
worried
about the ball at all?
Okay.
Yeah, like I said, by its nature, this slipping correction is not coordinated.
I have no sight of that traffic, just 15 miles.
2150 Golf, roger, traffic no factor.
A little fast.
needs to be hard over into the wind and all the way back. All the way back, hard into the wind. There you go. That's nice. Flaps up. Heartbeat off. Let's go.
Not too bad.
No. See? You knew what to do. I just had to make you do it. That's going to be our last one. We're actually, and we might have to circle on downwind or something. We'll sort that out with tower here in a sec. We're going to lose our engine on downwind.
Once they your turnout, or you're correcting your climb out after completing approach.
I didn't hear him. What?
That wasn't for us.
060-2300-129.
Roger, thank you.
Yeah. Tower 80, box pop. This next one's going to be full stop, and we're looking for a short approach. We can extend the departure leg if we need to for spacing.
Skyrock 80, Fox, extend your departure leg for spacing. Jeff, you'll be following us, making a circle just now passing over the vortex.
Roger that, we'll extend about a mile and a half, 2 miles later, Fox truck.
Hey, could you take the control just for a second here?
Yeah, my controls. See how easy it is to get what you want?
129 square, your turn is the final.
Over something square now, 129.
Roger, Jeff, follow is 2 mile final, 1100.
That time, you know what I think's been screwing with me, Aaron, is I've been trying to keep that ball in the center as I come down.
That can happen when you're slipping.
Yeah.
Here's a slip. Look at the ball.
Right.
Are we going straight?
I think that's what was screwing with me. So if I just use my rotors just to line it up, I'm a lot better off, I think. All right, my controls.
Your controls.
Third option.
My controls. Your controls. We're not going to turn crosswind until we're over the slippery minnow.
Okay.
You can level to 1500, but basically I'm buying us some space.
80 Foxtrot, left post shot approved.
Echo Tech approved, 80 Foxtrot.
We're going to go a little further here. Traffic is in a 1 mile right base to follow.
Watch that. Oh, you can go ahead and turn crosswind. He's not going to be any factor. So on downwind, we're going to fail the engine. We're going to take a breath. We're going to pitch the airplane for best glide speed, which is 65 knots, and then determine, do we need to turn the runway right now, or can we extend our downwind a little bit? And then we're just going to land, because we're on downwind for a runway. Why should we do anything else?
Okay.
Normal downwind, normal everything. I just did a little bit of extra coordinating to make sure we get the sort of approach that we want.
And you're going to cut power on me, is that right?
Yep. Hey, go ahead.
2150, Gulf, turn left, taxi there, Bravo, without delay.
Turn left, Bravo, Roger, Gulf.
Alright. Gas on both, undercarriage is down, mixture set, power set, seat belts and harnesses.
There's number one, wing up on the base of final turn right there.
Dogging 80 Foxtrot, trap follow with short final.
And slide 80 Foxtrot.
Roger.
Best glide, so go ahead and trim that nose up. We need to pitch up. 65 knots.
Pitch it up, you say?
65 knots. 65 knots. That's your best glide speed. Alright, let's go ahead and turn base. We gotta make this runway now. 65 knots. Trim forward if you need to. 65, you're doing 75.
Roger, golf, clear runway 19er.
65, pitch up.
Ground.
Trim the nose up, 65.
Okay, zero Foxtrot, runway 19 clear to land, make sure to approach your discretion.
Approach your discretion, clear to land 19 easier Foxtrot. The goal here is not to necessarily have this pretty square base, it's to make the runway. And to maintain our best glide speed at 65, we're going to lose less altitude for every foot we travel forward than any other speed.
Okay.
If we're faster than that, we lose too much altitude. If we're slower than that, we risk control issues. Turn coordinate to final.
Coordinate. Turn 129er. Number 9 or 5
129er, contact departure. Now, guess
departure, what? 9129er.
It's looks a lot like a landing, doesn't it?
Yeah, but we're
well fast. What tools do you have now?
Alright.
You're below 110. You don't want to overshoot the runway now that you made this heroic turn to the runway, so now use your tools to hit the runway.
Man, I'm having to fight this up, back.
There you go, wheel to control drift, feet to point the nose. It's just a normal landing at this point. Come on, control the drift. Use your feet. Go ahead and get off here at Bravo.
But I wasn't doing the slip correctly there, huh?
No.
Okay, sir. Foxtrot, turn left enable. Contact ground 0.910. Thanks for the help and the extension.
No worries, man. Left at Bravo. We got that made at ground 0.9. You did a great job today. Gold star for you.
Thanks.
I, however, didn't do too red hot today. Damn it.
And it's not the big stuff, it's the fundamental stuff.
I feel like I'm going backwards sometimes.
Let's talk about that after we get the airplane cleaned up and get on with ground.
Alright.
Bring it to a stop. What do we need to do clearing the runway?
Two, flap up. On.
Let's get the landing light and the strobes off.
Landing light, strobe, and we're going to switch to ground.
So we are clear of 1-9 on Bravo, going to the East T-Hang.
Quico ground, Skyhawk 80 Foxtrot is clear of 1-9, looking to taxi to the East Hangers.
Skyhawk 1-0-8-0 Foxtrot, Quico ground, taxi to parking via Delta.
Taxi to parking via Delta. 80 Foxtrot. Alright. Alright, I feel like I made some progress with the rudder control a little bit there at the end.
But you still weren't controlling your
drift. I was getting a lot better looking down the runway.
Well, you know where we're going to start with.
Sucked on the other thing.
We're going to do some low passes and get that Dutch roll back.
Yeah.
It's something that you've had. It's something that hasn't really been an issue the past couple of flights, and all of a sudden it cropped up today.
Yeah.
And the main thing I see, and you're going to see this when you go back to your video, on that last landing in particular, it's really illustrative. The nose was pointed down to the end of the runway, but you weren't doing anything about your drift. And what happened the minute I did this? The drift stopped.
Yeah.
Because the wind's from the left. So we got to focus on that. So we learned if we're down low and we lose the engine, yeah, like I said, you're going to learn a litany to restart the thing, but if we're below 1,000 feet on takeoff, we certainly don't have time for that, right? You had less than 10 seconds when I fell on takeoff. If we're on downwind, why don't we land the airplane and troubleshoot on the ground? The moral of the story is no matter where we're at in engine failure, our first couple of steps are going to have to be breathe, fly the airplane, figure out where we're going. Everything else is secondary to that. That's how we're going to, in essence, approach every engine failure. It's going to be those first steps. It's just going to be the case that we will, at some times, be in a position to try a restart. Down low like that, we're not.
Yeah.
If you're at cruise speed, which way are you going to have to pitch to slow down the best glide? Up. 65 knots. You're going to have to trim that nose up. And you saw, if we don't trim for best glide, it's real easy to let go of the controls, and all of a sudden we're speeding up again. Well, we don't want to be slower than best glide because we don't want to stall with no engine health to recovery with.
Well, let me ask you something, though. Why do you want to get rid of the speed that you have in the bank?
Because speed is not your friend. 65 is where you want to be. At 65 miles an hour, 65 knots, sorry, you are going to lose less altitude per foot traveled than at any other speed. You don't want to gain speed.
Even at 85, if you keep
65 is the number.
Okay.
They've tested it. If we're at 85, we are losing more altitude than we need to lose. And we've got, actually at 85, you're talking about 20 knot difference. You have a dramatically decreased chance of making the runway. So it's very important we keep it at the best glide speed. Again, below it, we don't want to stall the airplane without an engine to assist in the recovery, right? So we don't want to get below best glide. We don't want to get above best glide because we are losing more altitude per foot traveled above best glide than we are at best glide.
I see.
You are clear on the right.
Has anyone ever swung their tail into the building like this?
If your wingtip's clear of it, in most GA airplanes, you're going to have a hard time tagging a tail, but never say never. I've never seen it happen, but I can't swear that it hasn't happened.